Hey yo， 我是 Parker， 欢迎回到帕克英文，又来到每周两次的多益必考单字时间啦。这影片呢，依照惯例，在我们开始复习单字之前，要给同学们一个文法的测验题哦。进画面。如果需要时间观看题目的话，可以先将影片暂停，或者我等你三秒钟的时间。三、二、一，选好了吗？好，那在我们公布答案之前呢，也就先开始进行到今天30个以 Hiring and Training 聘雇与训练主题相关的多益必考单字。答案呢会在片尾跟同学们公布之外，到时候也会谈谈跟这一题相关的文法概念哦。好，那我们就不浪费时间，准备开始啦。 Here we go。
Proficiency 名词，熟练，精通。
His proficiency in English explains why he got the job.
他因为精通英文而得到了这份工作。
His proficiency in English explains why he got the job.
Trainee 名词，受训者。
The course gives trainees a chance to acquire skills to write formal business letters.
这门课程让受训者能有机会习得书写正式商务信件的技能。
The course gives trainees a chance to acquire skills to write formal business letters.
Conduct 动词，实施、执行、指引、指挥。
Experiments were conducted to see what effects these materials have on the environment.
执行一些实验是为了要看这些材质对环境有何影响。
Experiments were conducted to see what effects these materials have on the environment.
Lead 动词，带领、领导。
The position requires communication skills and ability to lead less experienced staff.
该职位需要具备沟通技能以及领导资浅员工的能力。
The position requires communication skills and ability to lead less experienced staff.
Independent 形容词，独立的。
We are looking for independent researchers with a master degree in biotechnology.
我们在找寻有生物科技硕士学位的独立研究人员。
We are looking for independent researchers with a master degree in biotechnology.
Disobedient 形容词，不服从的，不听话的。
Disobedient drivers may be fined or have their licenses suspended.
不服从指令的驾驶可能会遭罚或是驾照被吊销。
Disobedient drivers may be fined or have their licenses suspended.
Skilled 形容词，熟练的，有技术的。
The thief was so skilled that he didn't even scratch the lock he picked.
那个小偷技术非常熟练，撬锁也没留任何痕迹。
The thief was so skilled that he didn't even scratch the lock he picked.
Mentor 名词，导师，良师益友。
The online mentor service allows you to get advice from our highly skilled engineers.
线上导师服务能让我们技术绝佳的工程师给你一些建议。
The online mentor service allows you to get advice from our highly skilled engineers.
Achievable 形容词，可达成的。
I would not give the project the go-ahead if I didn't think it was achievable.
我如果认为无法达成，就不可能会启动这项计划。
I would not give the project the go-ahead if I didn't think it was achievable.
Hire. Hire. 动词，雇用、聘请。
I would like to hire Doris as our next general manager.
我想聘请 Doris 来任职我们下一任总经理。
I would like to hire Doris as our next general manager.
Conform to. Conform to. 片语，遵守，遵照。
The complex didn't conform to building safety standards and was therefore torn down.
那栋复合建筑物没有遵照建筑安全标准，也因此就拆除了。
The complex didn't conform to building safety standards and was therefore torn down.
Orientation. Orientation. 名词，培训，员工训练。
You will join an extensive orientation program taking you to all our divisions.
你将会参加一个培训活动，带你认识我们所有的部门。
You will join an extensive orientation program taking you to all our divisions.
Intern. Intern. 名词，实习生。
The central bank doubled its interns in 2019.
中央银行2019年把实习生的数量翻倍。
The central bank doubled its interns in 2019.
Capability. Capability. 名词，能力，才能。
The decline in capability is the reason why the elderly have to stop driving.
年长者不能再开车的原因就在于能力的衰退。
The decline in capability is the reason why the elderly have to stop driving.
Objective.Objective. 名词，目标，目的。形容词，客观的。
Judges should always try to be as objective as possible.
法官应该要一直尽可能保持中立客观。
Judges should always try to be as objective as possible.
Employee. Employee.名词，员工，职员。
Mr. Miller is a founding employee at this firm.
Mr. Miller 是这间企业的创始员工。
Mr. Miller is a founding employee at this firm.
Acquaint. Acquaint. 动词，使，熟悉，使，了解。
Please acquaint yourselves with the company's rules and regulations.
请各位一定要熟悉公司的规章制度。
Please acquaint yourselves with the company's rules and regulations.
Motivate. Motivate. 动词，给，动机，激励。
The sales manager has the ability to motivate staff to achieve established goals.
销售经理有能力激励员工达成设立的目标。
The sales manager has the ability to motivate staff to achieve established goals.
Strive. Strive. 动词，努力，奋力。
We strive to provide optimal service to our customers.
我们努力地要为客户提供最佳的服务。
We strive to provide optimal service to our customers.
Oversee. Oversee. 动词，监督，监管。
The board plans to hire a project manager to oversee the budget and progress.
董事会计划要聘一位专案经理来监督预算和进度。
The board plans to hire a project manager to oversee the budget and progress.
Intensive. Intensive. 形容词，密集的。
The two-week intensive training exhausted the players.
为期两周的密集训练让球员们精疲力尽。
The two-week intensive training exhausted the players.
Discipline. Discipline. 名词，纪律，训练。
Nick is a man of discipline. He wakes up at 5 o'clock every morning.
Nick 很有纪律，他每天早上都5点起床。
Nick is a man of discipline. He wakes up at 5 o'clock every morning.
Confuse.Confuse. 动词使困惑。
Bad communication will only confuse the employees further.
不良的沟通只会让员工们更加困惑。
Bad communication will only confuse the employees further.
Novice. Novice. 名词新手。
Most novice investors start out by putting their money into investment funds.
大部分新手投资客一开始都把钱丢去投资基金。
Most novice investors start out by putting their money into investment funds.
Compulsory. Compulsory. 形容词，强制的，义务的。
In this company, it is made compulsory for the salary to be paid into a bank account.
在本公司，薪水都是强制汇入银行账户。
In this company, it is made compulsory for the salary to be paid into a bank account.
Apprentice. Apprentice. 名词，学徒。
He served as an apprentice for 2 years before becoming a carpenter.
他当了两年的学徒才成为一位木匠。
He served as an apprentice for 2 years before becoming a carpenter.
Generate. Generate. 动词，产生，引起。
Natural gas can be used as a replacement of coal to generate electricity.
天然气可以用以取代煤炭产生电力。
Natural gas can be used as a replacement of coal to generate electricity.
Countdown. Countdown. 片语，依赖，依靠。
We can count on Sabrina to have the project finished tonight.
我们能依靠 Sabrina 在今晚将专案完成。
We can count on Sabrina to have the project finished tonight.
Rigorous. Rigorous. 形容词，严格的，严厉的。
All managers must complete a 3-day rigorous training course.
所有经理人必须要完成为期3天严格的训练课程。
All managers must complete a 3-day rigorous training course.
Dispatch. Dispatch. 名词动词，派遣。
An engineer has been dispatched to the branch office in Denmark.
公司已经派遣一位工程师前往丹麦分部。
An engineer has been dispatched to the branch office in Denmark.
Yeah, 复习完了影片的单字，过后又来到片尾解题的环节啦。还记得一开始给同学们一个文法的测验题吗？要如果忘了的话，进画面，再给你3秒钟的时间作答哦。3、2、1，准备好了吗？ 好，那我们就来正式解题啦。就这一题呢，我们可以看到四个选项的单词都是相同词首不同词尾的字眼嘛，所以显而易见的这一题的考点又是跟词性相关的。那我们就从这四个选项的词性开始判断。首先 A 选项的 generate 是个单数动词，意思是产生。再来 B 选项 generation 是个名词，意思一样也是产生。再来 C 选项的 generated 以 ed 做结尾，它有两个词性，第一它可以当作个动词的过去形式使用，第二它也可以是个被动的形容词。最后 D 选项的 generating 以 ing 做结尾也具备两个词性，第一它可以当作个动名词用，也同时具备着名词的功能，第二它也可以是个主动的形容词。好，目前我们算是把四个选项的词性给判断完毕。那接着我们可以观察得到，空格的前后分别有一个介系词的 of， 再加上一个名词的 electricity， 就这个位置再怎么样我们都不可能放入一个动词进来嘛，所以我们就可以把 A 选项的 generate 给删除。那接着我们可以从语义的角度来切入，看到一些字眼A goal of 空格 electricity for its own use， 意思是目标要产生电力以供字体本身使用。就语义而言，我们并不是要拿这个产生的意思来当作形容词修饰后方的 electricity， 所以借此我们可以认定形容词不是我们要的答案，那也就因此 C 选项可以接着删除。接着剩下 B、D 两个选项，分别一个是名词，另一个是动名词嘛。我们要如果想知道答案是哪一个才对，就必然的得要分辨好，究竟一个动名词它跟一个一般名词之间有怎么样的差异，我们要怎么样去做区别。一个英文句子里面，名词主要起到三个功能，分别可以当作主词、受词跟补语使用。那动名词呢，我们也就是拿一个原形动词，在其词尾加上 ing 的结果，把它转化成一个名词出来的结果。也就因此，动名词的功能就提供给我们一个字眼，它同时保有动词的词性，也可以具备名词的功能。那我们就用以下的例句来了解。第一个例句 Diving is my favorite sport， 意思是潜水是我最爱的运动。在这个例句当中，动名词的 diving 它是拿来当作主词使用的。第二个例句 We don't consider buying a new house， 意思是我们不考虑买一间新的房子。在这个例句当中，由动名词 buying 起手的片语是拿来当作 consider 的受词使用。再来第三个例句Her specialty is fixing computers， 意思是她的专长是维修电脑。在这个例句当中呢，由动名词 fixing 起手引导的片语是拿来当作主词补语用，用以修饰前方的 specialty。从以上三个例句我们可以看得出来，一个动名词它就具备了跟一个基本名词一样的功能，分别可以当作主词、受词跟补语使用。那一个动名词又具备怎么样的特点？它跟一个名词又有怎么样的不同呢？首先，一个一般名词可以当作单数或复数使用，但是一个动名词是用以指涉某一单一的事件，所以只能够做单数使用。像是例句 ，Working overtime is common in the design industry。意思是在设计产业里面加班工作很常见。在这个例句当中 working overtime 这个动名词片语是做主词用，算作单数，所以要搭配单数的动词 is。 再来第二个差异，一般我们都是拿形容词来去修饰名词嘛，但是动名词它本身具备着动词的性质，所以它是可以被副词修饰的。像是例句 Doing exercise regularly is good to your health， 意思是规律的做运动对你的健康有益。在这个例句当中呢，动名词的 doing exercise 因为它本身指的是一个动作，它可以被副词的 regularly 修饰。再来第三个差异点，就是因为动名词本身就是从一个动词转化而来的形式嘛，所以它后方是有可能可以承接一个受词的。像是例句 They spend all the weekend cleaning the conference room， 意思是他们花整个周末的时间在清扫会议室。在这个例句当中呢， the conference room 是拿来当作受词使用，承受 cleaning 清扫的动作用的。所以从这个例句我们可以看得出来，一个动名词的后方是可能可以承接受词的。以上我们算是谈完了动名词的基本功能以及它的一些特点，很快的速度再帮同学们统整过一遍。如同表格所示，一个动名词呢，它具备着有动词的意涵，是算作单数使用，可以被副词修饰，而且后方可能可以承接受词。那请记好以上动名词的各个特点，我们再回到今天的题目当中。还记得我们刚刚讨论的语义 A goal of 空格 electricity for its own use， 意思是目标要产生电力以供自己本身使用嘛。就这语义看来呢，名词的 electricity 似乎它是做受词用，拿来承受产生的这个动作的。要如果能够承接受词的话，我们在空格里面就应该要填入一个动名词进来嘛。所以就因此我们可以把 B 选项的 generation 给删除，最后再把正确答案的 D 选项套入句子当中，我们整句解读过一遍。句首大写。The factory has a goal of generating electricity for its own use from solar power. 意思是，工厂目标要用太阳能来生产自己所需的电力。寓意如此。好，今天的解题到此就算结束。解题环节过后，依照惯例要给同学们三题跟我们刚刚谈到动名词与名词之间差异的文法题目，要留给同学们烧脑啦。再请同学们把你觉得正确的答案留在下方的留言栏目，我会再去帮大家检查啦。最后，要如果喜欢我的影片的话，请帮我按赞加分享，又或者你在准备多益考试的当下遇到什么样的问题，也欢迎在下方留言栏目让我知道啦。好，这期影片到此就算差不多啦。我是 Parker， 这是帕克英文，我们下期影片再见啦，拜。